Hello everybody, welcome to the channel. My name is JGOD, and today's video we're going to focus on a few different tactics that you can use to improve, and then that'll hopefully lead to more kills and more wins, and just a combination of different factors that go into actually improving as a player within a battle royale, and specifically Warzone. I'm going to be using the MP7 with the sniper combo, and in the gameplay you're going to see here, we're actually playing trio quad, so we are actually down a player compared to pretty much most of the players in the lobby. If you do enjoy the content, let me know by hitting the like button. I do have a goal in today's video of 1,000 likes, so if you help me hit that number, definitely appreciate that. And if you're brand new to the channel, or you're part of that 87% that hasn't yet subscribed, definitely hit the red subscribe button with notifications on, so you'll be able to find your way back for more Modern Warfare content. Let's get into the gameplay breakdown. Understanding that the best time to play aggressive is on landing and the first portion of the match. As long as pretty much everyone on your team has a gulag, then you're in a good position to play confident, because at the end of the day, worst case scenario, you go to the gulag, and you got a 50-50 chance of coming back. Higher skilled, probably a little bit higher. Lower skilled, maybe a little bit lower. But how else are you going to improve unless you put yourself in those individual scenarios? Playing a low man can be very difficult to do, but if you guys stick together, it can actually pay off and go a long way. Use a lot of communication and then like choose a landing spot that's going to work for you guys to get loot, get in, get out, and then move to the next objective, or at least the portion of the mat you want to work. So I land on a roof, get a gun, end up seeing a guy get an engagement with the teammate here. Down, break the armor, easy kill there. And normally you're gonna get most of the kills in the beginning of the game and towards the end of the game. Usually the middle of the game isn't that action packed, unfortunately, unless you kind of just get lucky and you get the movement to where there's groupings of people where you can get in third party, calling those UAVs, getting stacks of money, where you can just go from player to player to player and play very fast. Or you gotta take the risk and use vehicles. Obviously people who throw C4 at you. I mean, there's a lot of variables, but the key is to get a weapon that you feel comfortable getting in a gunfight with. And unfortunately, that's not always going to be the case. But normally, if you're able to clear an area, you can usually get everything you need out of that specific area to move or at least get that loadout drop. So the beginning portion here is I'm just trying to get a weapon I'm comfortable with. For whatever reason, I actually like the Iron Sight Odin than that particular variant. With the base one, I'm able to hit my shots. That one, not so much. I think whatever they have on it, it just doesn't make it feel right. And then I'm coming around the building. I did see the guy come out, and then I'm trying to go for a flank. And you kind of see we're hanging out together, not necessarily holding each other's hands, but listening for any cues. I see a guy's over here. I'm looking for him. He calls him out, and then I'm not seeing him. And then I'm pretty much aiming to take that guy out. Break his armor. He's pretty much one shot. He decides to peek again for whatever reason and gets destroyed. He's downed. And we got to imagine that there's other players here because no one has to self-revive at this part. So I end up downing two players. Another person comes up. I got to be worried about the ammo. I really only have a mag and a half, so it's not the best position. Feeling like the area is clear, but since those weren't team wipes, I'm not really feeling like that was everybody. Teammate call out, come through, and this is just a basic looting phase. Sometimes you can land a boneyard and there's nobody, and sometimes you can land and there's like five different teams there. This individual case ended up being like two or three teams. They kind of cannibalize each other. We finished it off. We end up finishing off and clearing out the entire boneyard. And that's just sometimes how it goes. And the bonus is that everyone is still alive as a result of just kind of sticking together, good communication. And your communication needs to be top notch if you're going to play low man, or you just need to be super accurate, on point, have the right loadouts. Like everything needs to be dialed in if you're going to be playing low man, just because normally you're going to run up against teams of four. And the other part that I didn't mention yet is sometimes it's a little bit easier to play aggressive in the beginning because most people do not have all their plates. Like you can see, we don't all have five plates just sitting here. On top of that, people don't typically have their loadouts, so they're going to be end up trying to fight you with maybe your top weapon with them not so good of a weapon. So a lot of times you're going to be able to push a little bit more aggressively early game and get off some easy kills that may have been a little bit harder if you went up against those people once they've gotten their loadouts. So in an effort to get a little bit more cash, we do get the scavenger contract, and that ends up taking us halfway across the map, or at least to the next section over where it's like 200 meters away. You can see that there's a recon going on, so you got to use all this information when you're navigating. Okay, there's potentially going to be a team there. Once the team is done getting the recon, odds are if they have a downed player, they're going to go to a buy station, and you got to use that, just that pattern of how people are generally going to play to your advantage. A lot of buy stations, expect people to be around buy stations, just kind of common sense at this point. regardless if you hear them or see them, most people are going to be at buy stations because they're going to get plates, UAVs, or other kill streaks. They're going to buy back their teammates. They're going to get loadout drops. There's tons of reasons for people to be at those individual stations. See if it's opened up or not, or if it's just stayed closed. That means no one's used it. And you can kind of figure out, okay, no one's been in this area yet. You could hear the chest. It should be relatively safe. And then you use that information to move ahead. Right now, you can see that we're sitting on a decent amount of money. So we are a little bit outside the zone. We did hear gunfire over here at the gas station. And the overall goal or the plan was to actually head in this direction and jump in the vehicle, because we know it's going to be an aggressive push out of the zone. Without a vehicle, you're pretty much not going to be able to outrun it. But we feel confident enough that, hey, you know what? We could take out this squad, run in there. They just bought someone back. They probably don't have their loadouts. They're going to be a player down, and we could go still take off in the vehicle and make the aggressive play. So that's all we're doing up here. I'm creeping up. I do see the guy over here. They didn't see me come around the flank. End up pretty much taking him down, finishing him off. And then you can see their teammates coming from the sky. One of the issues I think I could have taken advantage of, if I would have felt more comfortable with the rifle, is probably just downing this dude. But he literally just lands directly, jumps in the vehicle, and then that kind of eliminates our escape route. So sometimes you got to be aware of that too. I could have probably played that a little bit differently. And the downside is I have to blow up the vehicle because the guy is literally right here. And we end up having to get caught by the zone, clear the guy out, and then we all pretty much die and go to the gulag. So pretty much I come out of here, I end up winning my gulag. And then once I win the gulag, it ends up winning the gulag with clues, and T-Clean didn't make it out of this one. And then it puts us all the way on the other end of the map, which ends up working out. Because there's a loadout drop. It ends up being perfect timing. We're still going to get our full loadout. We didn't lose any money. I'm sitting already on 7 kills, which is a decent start. If you're trying to go for a high kill game, you got to play aggressive. It's just not going to happen by accident. I mean, there are scenarios where you could just get into a load of kills and then you pick up all the kills just because they end up being one shot. But you're not going to really bank on that. So right here, we end up seeing there's a vehicle coming in. There ends up being more loadout drops over here. The guy coming in crashing jumps out to jump on the loadout drop. He's on the left side. You can see he's getting shot at by someone down low. So it looks like they're fighting it out there. So there's still someone on the buyout drop that this teammate was kind of helping out. So there ends up being 3 people there. One gets killed. The other one's on the top. I end up hitting them, breaking their armor, but I don't really have a lot of ammo. So that's one of the good things with picking up a sniper rifle right away or getting fully loaded. I downed the guy, and you can see he immediately goes for that self-res, which is kind of unfortunate that we got to cycle all the way around the map. At this point, we already know the guy is self-revived. There's no way he would have died by the time I walked up here. So as I'm coming up, we're kind of coming up together as a team, staying relatively close, using the information from the minimap. And one thing I did not notice, for whatever reason, it looks like there's people coming back from the gulag. If you look at the top left here, and you can see that there's 2 of them, I think, that land. And because I was looking at this, I end up focusing on the enemy, and my eyes were diverted away from that part of the screen. It's easy to see now in hindsight, but when you're actually focused on this, getting the information and looking at where the person's going to be, I didn't see this guy dropping out of the sky. I was kind of looked down, and then there was movement, so I immediately tracked towards that. And then it looks like more people are landing on the bottom because there's the loadout drop. So this ends up being kind of a little bit of a hotter drop than I expected. I do see the guy, end up pretty much lasering him from the sky. And then my teammate starts to get sniped. I didn't know exactly where they were getting sniped from. All he said was he got sniped. I figured it was up top. So all I did is try and get to a little bit of cover and then revive. Turns out the guy was down low. He didn't know where he got sniped either. He just got destroyed, and then that was pretty much it. So I end up peeking out and end up seeing the light. And once I see the light, then I'm able to readjust and I take a position that was a little bit more unorthodox. I'm still thinking the person's up top. There are people up there. We just didn't see them. Seen the light. I go reposition. Then I jump up. And then I go ahead and snipe this dude pretty cleanly. He's kind of mounted up, so he didn't necessarily see me correctly. Then I'm able to revive my teammate. One thing I did want to show the contrast here is one of the main tactics that we're utilizing here is the changing of pace based off scenario. The beginning, full speed ahead, running at everything, being as aggressive as possible. This one, playing patiently and dealing with the scenario at hand. We're obviously 2 people low now because we still got to get T-Clean from the buy station. We don't have enough money. He's going to end up jumping down after I revive him. And then maybe I can go to the prison and try and pick up a little bit of cash. Maybe it's not fully looted. And just because of good timing, you're going to see that I end up kind of jumping around. And then there's a couple team that's still already sitting there. They end up being in the bottom of the prison, looting it. And then they happen to come up and we kind of just cross paths without even knowing it. As I walk through, I end up seeing a recon beacon, and I'm knowing, okay, how many are right there? For sure there's one. I thought he was coming this way because it said 16 meters, but what really was happening was the guy was running underneath and working up towards his teammates. So he was the closest one towards me, even though he would be literally standing like right here if he was 16 meters away, closer. So odds are he was down below. And then I'm thinking, okay, where the heck this guy go? And then there's three of them. So I peeked this, take the angle, and in my head, I'm already strafing back into cover because I know there's going to be multiple. If they're peeking, I'm going to try and get an easy pick. There's a lot of different things going on here. So I get two of them. That guy ends up lasering me. And then the other one's trying to back him up. He's probably plating. I come out, and I don't know how I get lasered here, but the guy still has a good angle on me. At least I'm able to finish one guy off. I don't have any plates. I could have probably bought plates in the moment. You know, hindsight, I could have bought plates. Maybe I would have been short on getting money for T-Clean. So I kind of peek out. And really what I'm trying to do now is buy time for my teammate, because they went down to kind of loot those two people because they each had like $500 cash, or at least they got one of them, right? Snipe that guy. And pretty much I'm going to hold the angle. They could work all the way around and try and get me that way. But I'm just holding the angle. They're assuming that I got this locked down. They don't know how many people that it's me. They could think it's just me or somebody else. And pretty much I'm just buying time until my teammate gets there. So this is where the patience come in. I could push up, be aggressive, no plate, then pre-aiming. I get destroyed. And then now my teammate is at a huge disadvantage. We got to get this trade out and win the gunfight. So all I'm doing, like I said, buying time. Once my teammate's here, now I know where the location is of these two guys. I'm just not sure if they're up top or down low. And what I've done here is you can see I marked that area, and now I'm using that in combination of the heartbeat sensor. It says 31 meters, so it says they're actually a little bit closer in this direction. So they're either going to be in this window up at the top, if they made it up there, or in the bottom. And that's pretty much the only two options of where I'm going to be able to see them if they're at 26 meters away that the heartbeat sensor was telling me. So I end up pre-aiming that spot, and then I put my marker actually close enough up here so that if I saw some movement up top, I can make the adjustment. If I see it down low, I'm going to make the adjustment. And that's pretty much what you're seeing here. I'm pre-aiming. As soon as the guy peeks, snaps in, teammate's going to rush in. They don't know that he was that close because he crouched, walked in there, took him out, already up to 12 kills. I had to play passive and slow, not necessarily how I'd like to play, but when you're playing low man, you got to change that gear. And if you have to camp, you have to camp. That just makes sense. In this particular case, I had to play passive, put our money together enough to get T-Clean back. We're getting armor plates. We're going to hopefully have a UAV if we had enough money. So we can do all that right now. And then what we're going to do is grab a bounty so we can get additional cash. He ended up landing low. You can see him over here in the ditch, which ends up getting him the loadout. So we all have our loadouts now, and we're pretty much in good position. He probably needs a few more plates. He probably needs a little bit of ammo. You can kind of see where the bounty is. We'll kind of zoom out once we get a little bit closer, and he's going to be able to see the bounty before I do. What I'm going to do here is a lot of times I know I'm in a safe spot, so I'm going to call in on the mini map or the map, and I'm going to mark the exact area where the bounty is. So when I look, I'll have a visual indicator of where I'm supposed to be looking and kind of have an idea of where the enemies are going to be. So that's pretty much all I'm going to do here. I zoom in, I mark it as close as possible, and you can see where my orange marker is pretty much to this left area. So they're pretty much behind there. He's saying they're behind the green rock, or the blue marker is right behind there. And then what I'm deciding is, okay, if I need to push, my blue teammate is getting, T-Cleans are getting a different angle, and then we got to push up kind of all together. And the thing right here is we're going to third party, because they ends up saying, hey, they're in an engagement. Let's get down there while we can. They don't even know we're here. They're fighting each other. So I kind of rotate out, just try and see them. And we're kind of just giving intel to kind of spot them. You can see now there's coming up on the mini map here. And I got to go ahead and just kind of focus and see what's going on. So I line up. I mark the one on the right. Peek again. Miss a couple shots here. Obviously, I'm not the perfect sniper, but I do end up getting a clean hit there. Got the flinch protection there a little bit. I wish I could have landed another shot, but I did break the armor, so that's going to be a down. T-Clean was able to finish that guy off that I hit, and now I'm going to go ahead and hit this guy behind the tree. Worked out perfectly. So I end up breaking the guy's armor. T-Clean finished him off. So either way, that's where teamwork comes into play. Doesn't really matter the kills, in my opinion. I think it really considers like the damage and that you get the win. So you just got to play your role and not be greedy. I mean, I could have been greedy, stood out there in the open, maybe died, and now it's a 2v2. and we're not able to get the scenario that we want. Versus in this scenario, we get two downs, there's three of us, and there's only one guy left. We get the bounty, and we're able to come up on a little bit of cash. So the thing here is we want to make sure we're plated, since we did lose a little bit of plates in that gunfight. Like I mentioned in the last video, plates are essential for the end game. If you don't have plates, a lot of times you're just going to lose purely out of just them having double the health. Because if somebody has three full plates and full health, that means they have 250 compared to the 100 that you have with just your regular health and no plates. So you're going to want to make sure you stack up on those. Those can be a lot of times more valuable than a UAV, especially if you have a heartbeat sensor. We came from the prison side. We know that there shouldn't really be any, most of the people shouldn't be on our left. This is the building I was marking that we need to get to. And pretty much the goal should be to strategically get to that building, or at least as close as that building as possible, because that's going to be the central spot once the zone closes. You kind of have a general idea, even though we haven't done any recons, we don't know exactly where that is. So we're kind of pushing together. We're going to go towards this loadout drop and we're just seeing what's going on. I end up going into this building just to peek it. A lot of times you just got to cover your bases. I double check upstairs, peeking the window. We call in the UAV and then we know that somebody's gliding in on this left side, or they're just kind of out in the open coming down. And there is a guy on this right side. I wish I could have killed these guys a little bit more. Luckily, they had the perfect scenario where that guy was basically one bullet dead and he gets revived behind the smoke, and he probably has a thermal on. That's how he's able to hit me through the smoke. He has a thermal, so it's good strategy on them to have the thermal and the smoke kind of works together flawlessly. So that worked out for them. I end up peeking really quick, and then what I do is a level change, and I'm playing patiently with my teammates. Unfortunately, Clues did die, but T-Clean is still in a good spot. He's using over here this cover. There is like a rock there and a little bit of the house and the loadout drop. And then pretty much we're just going head to head with this team here. And this vehicle starts to creep up, which is unfortunate. And he's looking at him. He knows he has a C4. And that was probably the guy that landed late. He just landed on a vehicle because people are weird like that. Like we saw earlier in the gameplay. Landed on the vehicle, came at him. And luckily, T-Clean did have the C4. So I'm trying to get away from that building because pretty much I have to get to cover. And they were able to run because there was cover there. And pretty much I want to try and help them out here. The zone already closed kind of where we're at. So we're in a good spot here. Not likely to get pinched from this side. I mean, it could happen, but it's not as likely. That guy's pretty much one shot. I get to cover. T-Clean's providing cover for me as I get around the corner. And I'm able to plate up here, which luckily ends up, that could have been the loss right there because I would end up going down. So I'm coming up to help him out. You can see I'm low health. He's low health. I'm not fully plated yet. I throw my C4 in here. I have two of them. And then I rush up top. And then pretty much two things are happening here. He has a down that in the moment I didn't know about. And then the other guy completely break his armor. So right here that T-Clean doesn't have any armor. And that's going to make the gunfight fair. And you're going to see he ends up cleaning up real quick. So I end up downing the guy, even though I didn't get the kill for that because it was his kill. And then he ends up cleaning that guy that is basically one shot. So we cleared the house, teamwork. There was initially three guys, one downed, the other one downed, and then we end up getting all the kills together, which was pretty nice. Get the loadout drop, and this time I got a ghost loadout. Switch my weapons back to the HDR and the MP7, and then pretty much we got to deal with three teams, but based off the numbers, it's a low man three teams because there's us two, and then it's three solos. So we are in a good spot as long as we play smart, as long as we play together. We should be able to get trade outs and revive the other because there's only three players and they're likely going to play very slow because they don't know, or maybe they haven't done the math to figure out that it's a 2v1v1. So you can see the vehicles right here, seeing what they're going to do. I was thinking they were going to go to the buyback station, but they're just driving around being kind of weird. He ends up getting destroyed by T-Clean. He was getting lasered by that growl. And then you can hear somebody landing on the left. We end up shooting at that guy while the other teammate is coming in. So he ended up getting bought back, maybe? That was the case. I think he got bought back. That's why he had a pistol. See, he went to the buyback station. Oh, it is up there. I didn't notice it when I was playing. So he ends up coming back in. He got bought back. And then this C4, just unfortunate timing. I threw it a little too early, got out of the way. Teammate cleans him up. And we work together, laser that guy, and we end up in a 2v1 situation. So luckily, good communication. I dodged the car. Even if I didn't dodge the car, maybe I could have survived. That guy would have kind of pistoled me. and then T-Clean would have been a 1v1. But right now we're actually in a good spot. The only problem, we don't know if the guy's on the left or right, so we just got to play it together, play it smart. The UAV didn't show anyone on the right side or the left, so we pretty much don't know where anyone is at this point. And it is just one guy, so we just got to play it correctly and do what we need to do. So we take a different position, kind of still together. I use my heartbeat just to check the right. Good timing. I end up missing a couple shots here, but the guy ended up being one shot, and that's how we get the win. So even we're low man, we played it the right way, played patient, got to the objective the way we wanted. So that's a little bit what you got to do, is be able to change the gears. If you're struggling to improve at this game, I would try to land hot, get into those gunfights, and try to practice in those scenarios, because as soon as you get better at that, then the other phases are going to become a little bit easier, because most people are used to playing slow for a majority of the match. The end game is really only when you need to play a little bit slow, a little bit smarter, a little bit more passive, because you don't have a gulag. Beginning, you have a gulag, so go for it and try to improve with that through experience and practice. If you're trying to get your first win by camping and getting one kill, that's not it. It's not it, at least not in my opinion. Hopefully you guys did enjoy the video. If you did, let me know by hitting that like button. Again, a goal of 1,000 likes. And if you're brand new to the channel or not currently subscribed, hit the red subscribe button with notifications on by ringing that bell. We'll see you guys on the next one. Thank you for watching, and as always, have a great day.